In this video, I'll take a quick look at the Sharpe ratio and what it is. Sharpe ratios are typically used by investors to compare two portfolios. So we have portfolio A and portfolio B. Well, the problem with comparing these is that they're very rarely the exact same assets because, quite frankly, there's no need to compare that. So how do you find a way to compare the two in order to determine which one is better, which one is providing better returns due to either smarter decisions or just volatility, because it can be just dumb luck. The Sharpe ratio is named after William Sharpe. He was a Nobel laureate in the field of economics. He designed this a long time ago to be able to figure out what it is that makes a performance better than another one. And for that matter, you can have one portfolio, for example, A, skyrockets by 5% over the course of a month, but B may only produce 1.5%. But you find out later that A is much more volatile. And perhaps that's not what you want. So this is a way of kind of comparing the two to see how they would perform against what they call a risk-free asset. That is a treasury bill most of the time. So a US Treasury bond, for example, is considered to be about as risk-free as it gets out there. So how do they figure out the Sharpe ratio? Well, there is a mathematical formulation of this, and it looks something like this. It is your rate of return of your portfolio, and then you subtract a risk-free asset. In this case, almost all cases, it's going to be a treasury bill. And then you divide that by a standard deviation of the portfolio's performance. So, for example, the standard deviation you might use would be one standard deviation. So you take the performance, and you can just say it's, in this case, let's just say it's 5%, and you subtract from that the rate of return. In this case, just say it's 1%, so then you get 4%, and then you divide that by 2, and then you get your number down here. You find that the market then gives you a number, the ratio gives you a number, and then you can take this and maybe it's 7, and you take that and you see how that performs. The whole idea, of course, is that you have to figure out whether or not one performance is better than another, and this is a way of kind of smoothing that out, comparing apples to apples, because as I said before, the portfolios are not going to have the same assets. So, you know, you might have Canadian dollars in one, and instead of Canadian dollars in that one, you might have the Norwegian kroner, or you may have oil, and then over in this one, you have the FTSE, whatever. This is a good way to kind of measure the two against each other.